Welcome. So this particular course is named as Convective Heat Transfer. So Convective, it's a full 30 hours course, okay, in which we'll cover different aspects of convective heat transfer. Now, convective heat transfer is something that is there in our everyday life. Say, for example, if you take your room heater all the way up to a gas turbine engine, all the way up to air conditioning of a building, say, for example, flow through microchannels, okay, that means biomedical applications, then multi-phase flows, like for example, sprays, okay, which you would use to generate, say, for example, coatings on a surface or to burn fuel in a combustor. Okay, so in all aspects of life, you will find convective heat transfer. Okay, so convective heat transfer is basically the mode of heat transfer that is the most common, even if you don't realize it. And this mode of heat transfer is basically happens due to the flow. Okay, the flow is responsible for this mode of heat transfer. Okay, people who have already taken courses on conduction heat transfer, okay, we already know that conduction heat transfer is, for example, if you put a rod, if you heat a rod, right, how the rod becomes heated. Okay, say you heat one end of the rod, how the temperature rises on the other end. That would be a very typical conduction problem, right? Now, if you take that same rod and now you put it in a convective environment, okay, okay, the flow, due to the flow that is there, okay, around the rod, okay, the situation may be very different. Okay, in that case, we are not focusing so much on the rod, but how the heat is transferred from the rod to the fluid. Okay, so that could be a typical problem in a convective heat transfer, right? So, conduction heat transfer, whoever has taken the course, is basically a special form of the convective heat transfer problem. That means if you take the flow terms out, you basically end up with the conduction or a diffusion problem, basically. So, what we are going to do in this particular course is get a very generalized way of understanding what is convective heat transfer, okay. And as I said, that all problems in day-to-day life, okay, is basically works on convective heat transfer mode, okay. There is radiation involved also, which we are not going to cover in the course, but convection is by far the most common and the most popular mode of heat transfer. It is also used in heat exchangers, say for example, okay. So that means the heat exchangers that we use to take out heat, okay. So, so most of the time it is one of the important thing, and this builds up on the fluid mechanics understanding. Okay. So, in addition, if you have taken a fluid mechanics course, you will already know that there is a continuity equation that we solve, and then there are three momentum equations that we solve, right? So, convective heat transfer involves one more equation being added to the mix, which is basically the energy equation. Okay. And if it is a multiphase system, then you can have, of course, more number of equations. But multiphase system, we are not going to cover explicitly in this particular course. There is already another NPTEL course on this, where this is explicitly covered. Heat and mass transfer in multiphase systems, right? So, my name is Saptarshi Basu. I am an associate professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering at Indian Institute of Science. I am also an associate faculty in the Interdisciplinary Center for Energy Research. So, I basically do work on multiphase flows and combustion and heat transfer, okay? So, the books that we are going to follow and most of the lecture materials will be adopted from Professor Adrian Bejan's 2013 edition of Convective Heat Transfer. If you have a newer edition that is actually good, you just can cross refer and see, okay, which figures and pages we are actually referring to. For further readings, you can read K's, okay, so Convective Heat and Mass Transfer book, that is also for reference text. There are also numerous other books that are there, okay, so Burmester and other books. So, you feel free to read those books. There is no limitation, statutory limitations on which books we should read, but I am going to mainly follow Adrian Bejan. However, the turbulence part of the course, we will use our own notes, completely our own notes. So, this is how the course is going to pan out. Okay, we are going to do the introduction and then the governing equations. Governing equations essentially means solving for conservation equations. Then the first module, second module will be the external forced convection, in which we can, we will look over flow over flat plates, we will look at Faulkner scan types of solutions, we will look at scaling arguments, we will look at integral solutions, we will look at similarity solutions, okay, and similar things in that way, and look at specialized problems like constant heat flux boundary conditions, isothermal wall boundary conditions, intermediate, if a particular substance is heated in a patched up manner, what happens? Okay, so different types of solutions we will do. We will also look at suction and blowing. Okay, and then we will move to internal forced convection, where we will do hydrodynamically fully developed flows. What is the entrance length effect? What is the hydraulic diameter and pressure drops? Heat transfer to fully developed flows. Okay, in the developing regime, what happens? Okay, so all these things will be covered in during the course of many lectures. Okay. We will also then go on to natural convection, where we once again look at the scaling argument, similarity solutions, integral solutions, look at thermal stratifications, mixed convection modes, okay, the different types of enclosures that we have in internal natural convection, like shallow enclosure, partially divided enclosures, etcetera. We will also take a brief look at certain special cases like Rayleigh-Benard convection. We will also do an introduction to experimental techniques. Okay, that means normally most of these courses work on the principle that experimental techniques nobody covers. So we are going to give you an idea that how experimentations are done. Okay, modern day experimentations are done to find out different parameters related to the convective heat transfer, like Nusselt number, heat transfer coefficient, etc. We are going to spend quite a bit of lectures on turbulent heat transfer and turbulent flows, okay. And if time permits, we will do a little bit of analysis on microscale heat transfer and heat transfer in multiphase systems, okay. We will try to look at it towards the end of this course, okay. So this course is going to cover a wide gamut of materials, right from very canonical problems to some of the contemporary issues, especially in the area of turbulent heat transfer. Okay, but it is mainly going to focus on the forced convection and natural convection, okay, internal and external both. So there are like four main categories of flows that we are going to consider. We are going to give you an in-depth idea of how scaling arguments are performed, what are the different important parameters, how to think out of the box, how to use your common sense and use your logic to bring out certain key insights into the problem. Okay, rather than learning things by heart. Okay, so it's not a problem driven thing, it's more an understanding driven course. Okay, and we are going to follow that kind of a trajectory using canonical problems, how you can solve certain things from using your scaling arguments and your logic. Of course, we are going to look at the rigorous solutions as well. Okay, so this is in a nutshell what the course will be all about. Okay, so in 30 hours is very exhaustive, and we will pretty much is a one semester course. So I mean in a standard institute. So we will try to cover the whole convective heat transfer, okay, with more emphasis on the natural and the forced convection part. Okay, so welcome to the course, and we will see you from next class.